In this video, I will show you how to test and disassemble a car's alternator. Step by step in details. This faulty of no charging alternator has DC 12 volt and 130 amperes capacity. And I am going to do a couple of testing to see what is the problem with it. Firstly, alternator's diodes for its rectifier testing by using a multimeter with diode position selected. Contacting the multimeter's black probe to alternator's positive terminal and red probe to alternator's body. Reading from the meter was continuing and this is good. Doing the way around by meter's probes and no continuing reading and that is good. These have confirmed the alternator's diodes for its rectifier are in good shape. Secondly, rotor's winding excited testing. Connecting a red wire for batteries positive to the middle pin in the socket. And black wire for batteries negative to the body of alternator. Those wires are any kind of the ones can stand for 10 amperes. Bring a 12 volt battery in and connecting red and black wires to battery's terminals accordingly. At the same time one hand turning alternator's pulley. A rough turning should be felt if the rotor's winding excited. However, this was not a case. So alternator's regulator, its brushes, rotor's winding, or stator could be at faulty. Disassemble alternator needs to be done. For disassembling alternator, undo 4 long bolts here. Then pulling the pulley with rotor together out from the main body. Stator is secured by 6 screws inside on diode's rectifier with the rest of components. Undo those screws, then pull stator with its coil out from main body. As showed here, alternator's rotor assembly on the right, stator in the middle, and diode's rectifier with regulator assembly on the left. This part is regulator, bolted on diode's rectifier assembly. Diode's rectifier with case, regulator, stator, and rotor's assembly have been separated for testing. For the testing purpose, no needs further deassembling. These 12 diodes are divided by 2 groups separately, which act just like 2 big diodes. A multimeter's diode position can be selected to test these diodes. Diodes forward are okay. So do their backward. Selected ohm position to test 2 groups insulation. 2 groups are separated and good. These diodes could also be tested by another way like did at the beginning. However, that way of testing could not be known 2 groups were separated or not. The test confirmed those diodes of 2 groups are not contacted each other. And they are okay. The same 2 coils combined in parallel made a stator's coil. And each separated coil has 3 terminals. Using a multimeter zone position to test coil's continuance between terminals. All has good continuance with the same resistance of 0.1 ohm between any two terminals for each coil. Two separated coils are not contacted each other. Testing rotor's winding resistance. It should be a couple of ohms between two brass rings. Should not be continuance between any brass ring and rotor's body. All good. Last thing to be tested. This regulator. In fact, it must be at faulty because the other components have been confirmed in good shape. What I am going to do. Instead of hooking wires involved to test regulator here, I have an idea and modify this regulator to let it work again for testing purpose. I have done so such as bypass the faulty part of regulator, which soldered two wires to each brush. The one is for positive, and the other is for negative. This is a 2.2 μF capacitor, and its value is the same as the original one, which is here. It has to be taken away to make a space for those of two wires. A capacitor will be connected to the two wires soldered to the brushes, after assembled. Now the modified regulator is fixed to its position. Yellow wire is for a brush at front, and black wire is for a brush at rear. The black wire here will be pinned to a red wire for batteries positive. The stator has been put in its position. And make sure to tie all of 6 screws. Two brushes have to be pushed into their position in order to fix rotor into its position. Insert a suitable hard wire into back hole here by one hand. Then using a hook-like tool by other hand to push rear brush down at the same time pushing the hard wire further into back hole. And repeating the same way for front brush. All done. Let the hard wire stay there until the rotor is fixed into. This is the red wire for battery and has been pinned to the black wire for the one of brushes. The other wire with brush has been contacted to alternator's body. Now carefully placing the rotor into alternator's main body. using a multimeter to check resistance between the red wire and body. It should be just a few ohms. Yes. It's okay. Now this alternator is ready with a load testing. Two brackets have been installed for testing stand. And this red wire is going to connect batteries positive. Plus a few other wires need to be connected properly. This is a switch which will switches on battery power by hand to excite rotor at the beginning. That is metal bridge rectifier which in this case connected as a diode function for letting the alternator's output supply DC 12 volt to continuing to excite rotor and a load. However blocking DC power from battery to alternator's output and the load all the time. A 21 watt car globe as a load. And also a multimeter has been hooked there to monitor alternator's output voltage. Red, black wire are connected to battery's terminals. And switch is off right now. This is 1800 revolution per minute drill. Alternator is working. And the output voltage is 15.4 volts with a load. Do it again. This has been proved alternator's regulator was faulty before modification done. That's it. Now you've known how to test alternator and diagnostics its components successfully. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.